Welcome back once again, everyone. Prestige here, and I got a quick video for you today. We're going to be taking a look at the Sentinel Personalization Pack for Call of Duty Ghosts, and it will also be available on Call of Duty Black Ops 2. In order to receive this pack, all you need to do is go and pre-order Call of Duty Advanced Warfare, and that can be pre-ordered at GameStop or any other major game retailer like Game UK if you're in the United Kingdom. But first things first, let's take a look at this camouflage. It's shown on the Honey Badger for Call of Duty Ghosts. If I were to show this camouflage to somebody that has never seen a weapon with camouflage on it before, they'd probably think that this is just the original color of the weapon, you know, without any camouflage at all. It's not too flashy, but what I really like about it is it reminds me of the Peacekeeper original, just no camo, and that's what I like about it. The Peacekeeper was awesome, that white color when we had our first DLC weapon ever. The Peacekeeper just kicked ass, and it still does to this day. But that's not really what makes this entire pack up. What really makes this pack is the patch, player card, reticle, and player background. The patch, as you can see, is a Sentinel Task Force patch. And I'm not sure if this emblem is going to tie in with the single player at all for Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. I'm really interested in to see how it does play into the game, but I really like the emblem itself. It's like a Spartan helmet with a, you know, just kind of like a wingspan on the side of it, which is really cool. The player card is basically the cover art for Call of Duty Advanced Warfare, which I'll go ahead and put up on the side of the image as well, so you can go ahead and see it side by side. The reticle is once again just that Sentinel Task Force emblem, which has some coloring. It's kind of like a greenish, yellowish, reddish, which is really cool. I really like how it fades out a little bit. And then the player background just kicks so much ass. I think it's so cool. The way that they did the color scheme, like on that black on gray, it's kind of like a steel on matte color. That just looks really, really cool. And I'm definitely going to be pre-ordering this game really soon, but I kind of want to hold off a little bit because I know GameStop likes to do other little bonuses, like they did the pre-order bonus for Call of Duty Ghosts where you get the ghost mask, but you also get like a poster. I want to wait and see if we get a poster, but if you guys are wanting to get this camouflage, it does come out on May 13th, I believe. Yeah, May 13th. That's when it will be available in-game. Make sure to go get your pre-orders as soon as possible. There's actually probably going to be an end to this at some point, so if you want to get in on the action, make sure to go to your local GameStop or Game UK. I know that you can pre-order it online and still get the actual code itself, so once you guys do that, definitely redeem that, or you know, do some giveaways or whatever you do. I know a lot of people don't like camouflages at all or any type of pre-order bonus, but I'm definitely gonna wait for the poster itself. I would like to have a poster. They've been doing that since I don't even know when, the forever. I mean, I've had one since, you know, the original Black Ops, so, and I think I had one for Modern Warfare 2 and Call of Duty 4. I've always had a poster, so that's one thing I'm going to be waiting for. But anyway, guys, thank you so much for stopping by the video. Thank you so much for watching. If you could, please do me the favor of leaving a thumbs up. I really do appreciate it, and we could break 1,000 likes today, no sweat. And if you have not yet, make sure to hit that subscribe button. We're going to be hitting 200,000 subscribers very, very soon here in the near future. Thank you all so much for watching once again, and until next time, I am out. Peace.